Hey, what's going on, everyone? My name is Greg Zuber, and I'm a pre-service physical education teacher from Burlington, Ontario. I'm super excited to be working with PHE Canada to introduce you guys to a brand new action-packed game called Racket Dash. It's geared towards physical education for students grades 7 to 12. Now, Racket Dash is supposed to be played in a wide open field, which is perfect for social distancing. It's a fast-paced, TGFU striking and fielding game designed to get the heart rate up, teach fundamental movement skills, and have enough differentiated instruction to cater to all athletes' needs. So without further ado, I present to you my game, Racket Dash. Gonna need some gloves. This is Racket Dash, a brand new striking and fielding game. It's designed to be played with 3 to 4 players. Due to its narrow design, multiple games can be played at the same time, all socially distanced, of course. To set up Racket Dash, you will need a tennis racket, a ball of your choosing, 2 markers, and 5 pylons. First, you're going to place 4 pylons in a square, about 6 feet apart from each other. Next, you're going to place the 5th remaining pylon a good distance away from your newly created square. The distance is up to you. Just know the farther the cone, the more running you'll be doing. Once that is set up, you'll want to directly align a marker with the first 2 pylons in the square. This is so there are no collision issues. Lastly, place the ball and racket inside the square and you're ready to go. Time should be awarded for a proper warm-up and cool-down before and after play. 2 to 3 dynamic stretching movements is encouraged, following a 2-minute jog around the playing area. Some examples include lunges, groin circles, high knees, butt kicks, twists, and Spider-Man crawls. Once we're all warmed up, it's time to play. One team starts at bat and the other is in the outfield. The team at bat selects the first batter and they enter the square. The other teammate waits patiently for their turn at bat. For the outfielders, there are 2 positions, pitcher and fielder. The pitcher takes the ball and steps on either marker. The fielder can choose to be on the left or right side behind the square. To accommodate all playing levels, Racket Dash allows for self-pitching, which means the batter steps with the ball, throws it up, and hits it without the need for a pitcher. This is easier for batters to hit the ball and can be more beneficial for some athletes. For this situation, there is no pitcher and 2 fielders. The left fielder lines up behind the left back side of the square, and the right fielder lines up on the back right side. It is up to the batter which style of pitch they prefer to use for their hit. When the batter is ready, the pitcher will underhand pitch the ball to them, or the batter will self-hit. There are no strikes, so play continues until the ball is struck. The ball must travel in front of the square in order for the hit to count. The ball is hit to the side of the square, it will not count and the batter must re-hit. Once the batter strikes the ball, the dash is on. The batter's goal is to see how many times they can run and touch the outer cone with their foot and run back to the home square. Every time they re-enter the home square, they earn a point for their team. The batter can run for the outer cone as many times as they wish, meaning multiple points can be awarded in a single hit. If the batter does not touch the outer cone with their foot, it will not count. The outfielders, on the other hand, have to get the ball back to one of the markers as quickly as possible to stop the batters from getting points. Play is deemed dead, and the batter's out when a fielder touches one of the markers with the ball in their possession. A fielder can receive a pass while having 1 foot on the marker to stop the play as well. Once the ball is hit, both the left and right fielders will sprint to the ball. They must coordinate amongst themselves, designating who should be the one to chase the ball and who should support. They are encouraged to pass the ball to each other, and use strategy to end the play as quickly as possible. This is the same for a fielder and pitcher combo, only the fielder will be the one sprinting to the ball and the pitcher will support. Once play stops, the next batter up will enter the square. The outfielders will rotate as well. The pitcher will become the fielder and vice versa, or the 2 fielders will switch sides. The batter can try to get as many points as possible during their run. They can continue running back and forth from home square to the outer pylon until the play is stopped. If a batter has returned to the home square 2 times, for example, and gets out on their 3rd run attempt, they will still be awarded 2 points because they made it back to the square twice. After all batters have hit, the points get tallied up and the teams switch sides. The batters become the outfielders and vice versa. The inning is over once all players from both teams have had a chance to hit, and then Racket Dash finishes after 3 innings. Surprisingly, there's a lot of strategy involved to be successful in this game. For the outfielders, strategy is everything. You must be constantly coordinating with your team. Generally, if the ball gets hit to the left, the left fielder would chase after it. The right fielder should be running as well, to be used as support. If the ball is hit down the middle, a good strategy is for one of the fielders to yell out, "Mine" or "Yours." Lack of communication could cost your team a point or two. There are different ways to support the one chasing after the ball. Do you close the gap between ball and mount, giving your teammate an easier pass to you? Or do you keep one foot on the mount to guarantee an end of play once the ball is passed to you? Batters have strategy as well. It is encouraged for them to choose whereabouts they want to hit. Do they want to hit the ball to the right, down the middle, maybe to the left? The option to choose whether to self-pitch or have a dedicated pitcher brings an interesting dynamic to the game. Athletes get to experience a sense of control by regulating their own swing comfortability and confidence. They can begin with a self-hit if they wish, and move on to actual pitches when they feel ready. These strategies and on-the-fly thinking are great ways to introduce players to the strategies of real baseball, as the skills learned Rakitash will carry over. Performance will be based on students' ability to strike the ball, sprint, pivot, throw appropriately, catch, and utilize teammates. Some great reflection questions include, have I grasped the concept of striking, sprinting with intention to slow down, changing direction, picking up the ball with accuracy, throwing and catching, game awareness? What strategies did I use to be successful? Some teaching cues to use are, make sure the racket is held with two hands when swinging. Focus on making contact when first starting. Don't worry about how far the ball goes. Don't be afraid of self-hitting either. Grasp the racket with one hand, the ball with the other, throw the ball up gently, re-grasp the racket with two hands, and swing. If pitching, make sure to underhand throw using a lob motion so that the arc descent matches with the pitcher's location. Make sure to use a pivoting foot when switching directions. Position yourself to make shorter throws or longer throws. Fielders, have a plan beforehand on what to do for different situations. Make sure your foot is on the marker if you're receiving a pass. Catch the ball with two hands. Slow down with control. Feel free to pause the game at any time to comment on player performance and point out areas of improvement. Rakitash is designed to be played with a tennis racket, however they can be substituted based on degrees of skill, such as a baseball bat, or a ping pong paddle, or even a hand. The ball can be substituted as well. Different balls can be used for different ranges. A softer ball will not go as far as a denser ball, but it might be easier to hit and safer to use. As mentioned previously, the distance between pylons can be changed based on how much running you want to do. The game requires different roles, such as the person who can run fast, versus a person who is better at throwing, versus someone who is better at catching. The fact that students are rotated after every hit ensures that everyone will have experience with each position. Baseball is a fantastic, tactical, and strategic sport. It involves multiple different skills to perform effectively. Unfortunately, baseball also involves a lot of waiting around. Rakitash is not only a great way to introduce these vital movement skills, but an exciting and fun sport in its own right. Am I saying that because I'm the one that invented it? Maybe. I guess you'll have to play it to see for yourself. For more activities, check out the PHE Learning Center at phacanada.com, as well as the Canadian Olympic School Program at olympic.ca. Stay active, everyone.